Hey guys, this is Aaron. Today we're going to take a look at our buddy, the measurements box. Measurements box is that little box down in the lower right corner of the status bar, or you can actually turn it on and have it float around in a window if you're on a Windows machine, or nest it into a toolbar. The measurements box used to be called the VCB. So sometimes you hear those SketchUp old timers talk about the value control box. That is now what we refer to as the measurements box. Now, a couple things about the measurements box. One is that it changes its name. So when you go into different commands, it'll actually change what it's called. This is important because it's not going to always call itself the measurement box. If you go into a line, it's going to say length. If I go into rotate, it's going to come up and say angle. This is going to change based on what command you are in. The other thing is that if I want to use the measurements box, say in this case I want to draw a length in, what I don't want to do is come in here and try to click in here. At any point that I want to type something in, I just go ahead and start typing. As long as you're in the screen, it knows that typing should go to the measurements box. So if you're in a command that accepts a measurements entry, you just have to start typing. Don't try to click into the field. The other thing that's nice about the measurements box is it will allow you to change values as you go. So right now I can see here as I'm moving my mouse, I'm getting feet and inches showing up. But if I wanted to, I could actually come in here and put in 100 millimeters, enter, and it will enter that length. Now, of course, if I go to check that length, it's going to give me the length to the nearest unit that I'm currently in this model, but it is actually input as the unit that I typed in when I drew the line. Something else to keep in mind is when I do come in here and draw something, so I'll draw a line that is 1 foot long, I can right now actually change that. Well, say I actually meant to put 6 inches. I can hit change that and hit enter. As long as I don't go to a different command, I can continue to type in new values. This is not just for line. This is for things like putting in rectangles or polygons, moving things. Anytime you type in a dimension, you can go in and type in a new measurement as long as you stay in that command. If I go into the rectangle tool, typing in a dimension for a rectangle is measurement, comma, measurement on US keyboards. Other keyboards will require you to use the semicolon to separate the two values, but typing those two numbers in separated by that separator, the comma or the semicolon, will allow you to put in dimensions for a rectangle. The measurement box can also be used with the polygon or circle tool. If I have that tool up, I can type in the number of sides I want to use, hit enter, and it will actually change right like that. Same goes for circle. Circles, of course, are going to be treated a little bit differently, but I can actually change the number of sides that I want to have the circle rendered at when I draw it, just by typing in the number of sides I want and hitting enter. If I take an entity and, for example, copy it using modifier key move, I can create an array by typing in slash number into the measurements box and hitting enter, or X number and getting multiple copies laid out. Again, that's using the measurements box by typing in X number or slash number. Another spot that the measurements box is used is in the field of view. If you go into the field of view command, you can type in a different field of view and hit enter, and that will just change it right there. Again, no need to click in the field or move anything. You can just start typing and hit enter to accept to change your field of view on the fly. And finally, if I want to draw a line to a specific coordinate, I can type that into the measurements box using the square bracket. So I picked a start point. If I want to draw a start point back to the origin, I open bracket 0, 0, 0, hit enter, and it'll take me back to the origin. That's an overview of the measurements box. Thank you.